It's with the jumper.
Yeah, he's a bit of a tit.
Are you
right?
Yeah.
We thought of doing this tomorrow or something. It's a bit rainy today. We could maybe do set up camp when it's sunny.
No, it'd be fine. We live in Britain. Also, tents are waterproof, which tends to help.
Yeah, true.
I've got enough stuff, haven't I? You just said just bring your work, didn't you?
Yeah,
just bring your stuff and I've got all the
got everything.
Heather.
Oh, Tom.
Yeah. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too.
Finally. Sorry. Dave has spare everything. Spare bedroll, spare sleeping bag, spare tent, everything. So, should be cool.
Yeah,
it's good, because I've just only done this a couple of times before and it's usually with my geology group at uni and usually pretty well prepared, you know, so.
What, camping?
Yeah.
We'll be alright. Don't worry about it.
Cheers. Hey, check this out. Oh yeah.
Okay, we're going.
Hi, my name is Heather Frost. I'm a third year undergraduate student at Stanford University studying social psychology. In this film, I hope to gather evidence to prove my theory that technology is damaging to mammalian life in the way of restricting physical potential and mental well-being. My project is entitled The Human Effects of Technology Abstinence and Nature Immersion. And the idea behind it is that myself and my cameraman Dave will be spending 1 week out here in the woods, completely secluded from any kind of outside civilization and living off the land. The only technology we have with us is pots and pans to cook with. The camera to record the video diaries, and tents and hammocks to sleep in. I'll be collecting qualitative data in the form of video diaries and mood questionnaires, and by the end of the week I expect to find that our moods will have lifted considerably and our physical fitness will have increased substantially. Tom, what are you doing?
Hey?
Have you got your phone with you?
Yeah, of course.
Did Dave not tell you? You know, we're not supposed to be bringing any kind of technology with us today.
phone, obviously. That's something that you'd be stupid to come out here without a phone.
Not really. I mean, you can't really get lost in Britain.
Just don't pay any attention to me, alright? I'm not part of your project.
Yeah, but you having the phone and blasting that noise really loud is going to affect me and Dave and therefore invalidate my results.
A bit of noise? I'll turn it down a bit, alright? Just ignore me. Just going for a piss.
It's day 3, and the initial shock of the cold temperatures and lack of Western food has worn off. I'm feeling much more at peace, sleeping better. I'm going to sleep when the sun sets and waking up as it rises, and I feel a lot more at peace with myself.
Okay.
I feel like I've had a good shower in days.
Oh, I don't worry about it. Our bodies are much better at handling a bit of dirt than people realise. Stress is much worse. Man, you have to admit you're getting used to this though, right?
It's a bit boring now, isn't it?
I don't know. I think you'll come to appreciate the tranquility of the natural world. And, apart from that goddamn motorway, you can hear it everywhere. It makes me sick that they just tear up the countryside just for the sake of it. Sparing a few minutes, yeah?
Yeah. How are you doing, Tom?
What?
Where you work, how are you doing?
To be honest, I'm way ahead of schedule.
There's not really that much to do around here either.
Why don't you come get some firewood with me if you've got nothing better to do? And stop worrying about getting a bit of mud on your shoes. Just relax.
It's more my socks I'm worried about. I haven't got any spare socks.
I'm not going to die with no socks.
Fine. Just give me a sec, I've seen you get my phone, because I put it on charge. Well, I've turned it off for a couple of days to save the battery life, so hopefully I've still got a decent amount of battery on it. Just going to grab my phone.
Guys, have you seen my phone?
I've let them pair go get the firewood. I'm not feeling very good. I'm a bit unsure about them mushrooms that Heavy picked last night. Yeah. I'm feeling really rough.
Do you know what you're after? It's like everything's wet here.
It's alright, there'll be some firewood somewhere, we just have to keep looking.
I've been walking nearly an hour. I mean, shouldn't we head back? We don't definitely need a fire.
Of course we need a fire. We need it for tonight and tomorrow. We need to cook, we need to boil water. I mean, we can't just go without. Also, we need to keep warm. Fire is like the best thing about this. It's like our best survival tool.
Okay.
We just have to find somewhere where wood's been sheltered overnight from the rain.
Heather, we should really start heading back soon. It's going to get dark, and if it gets dark on us, we're fucked. I don't think I can find my way back as it is.
For God's sake, Tom, you can't expect this to be a corner shop. Compared to the area you're in, this is a short walk.
I suppose if we do get lost, there's some motorway. Southeast, in that direction?
Yeah. If we get lost, we'll head towards the motorway, the artery of rushed misery. I'm sure the help is there.
Just because they get it at 70 miles an hour doesn't mean they're not people anymore.
Look. We're not going to get lost. You have absolutely no confidence in yourself whatsoever. If we don't find any dry wood soon, we'll head back. I'm not completely insane, you know.
Look, Heather, if I had my phone, we'd have some kind of flashlight. If it gets dark on us, we're buggered. We're not going to find a way back.
Fine, we'll go back. But you see how easy it is to get on without fire, tonight and tomorrow. Have anything to eat. Water.
Oh my God, you have no idea which way it is, do you?
Look.
Fuck, I knew this would happen. Shit.
Just calm down.
We're fucked.
Dude, it's okay. I know where we are. I know where we're going. Just keep following me.
Heather, Dave is at the camp sick. I've got no phone. It's starting to get dark.
Dave isn't that bad. Everything's gonna be fine. He'll keep the camp safe.
Keep the camp safe? You mean we're not going back tonight? We're gonna freeze.
Dude, it's not that big a deal. Just relax. People do this all the time. They spend the night out and they go back in the morning.
Well, let's just keep walking, all right? We'll find a way back.
Exactly.
If you want to sleep out here.
Okay, just calm down. Tom, just relax. Come sit down with me.
I knew this was going to happen.
Just sit down. It's not that bad out here. It's quite nice, actually.
It's freezing and it's wet as hell.
Look, we'll keep each other warm. We'll go back in the morning when it's lighter. It'll be easier then.
I hope Dave's okay.
Dave will be fine, you know what he's like, nothing much bothers him. He'll laugh at us tomorrow.
I thought this was normal.
No, I mean, he'll laugh at the fact you've had to spend your first night out here without a tent.
I hope we don't freeze to death out here.
I'm not going to freeze to death, it's not cold. So much worry. Just try and get some sleep.
Heather, you alright?
What's that?
So you okay then?
Oh, yeah. Of course I am. Let's get back to camp.
Yeah.
Alright. I think I know where we went wrong last night.
Well, you went wrong.
We need to head this way.
Wait, hold on. I can't see the tents.
See, I told you.
Dave! Sorry we took so long, man. Couldn't find any decent firewood.
Yeah, Heather got us lost.
Hey, Dave, you alright, man? You alright, man? Oh.
I'm a bit unsure about that.
Oh shit. Dave, come.
Oh shit.
Dave! Dave! Dave, wake up! Dave!
Oh, the smell. Do you think he...
It looks like he...
Yeah, he drowned.
It's because of me. Oh. I fucked this up.
Stop.
I fucking killed him.
Stop. For God's sake, Heather, don't do that. We don't have time for that. We need to ring for help, Heather. Heather. Heather, where's my phone? We need to find my phone.
Phone. Yeah. I put it... I mean... I think I saw you go over here.
What do you mean?
We can
what do you mean, I think I?
We can find it.
Heather? Heather.
I think I saw you.
Heather. 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 I think I put. Have you taken my phone?
Of course not.
Jesus Christ.
But you don't even. You don't even know why.
Do you want this to happen?
No.
You fucking
bitch.
How did
you say that?
You fucking bitch. God. Dave, it told me. You were a fucking psychopath! I would not have come on this fucking trip. You fucking idiot!
Stop! Oh, the fuck. Stop! I didn't want any of this! It was just an accident! I'm not a psychopath! There.
Switch on. No. No. Please, come on, switch on. Fuck. It's not going to switch on. We need to get to the car, like, now. Water damage, it's completely soaked. What did you expect?
A car.
Sorry, I didn't mean what I said.
It's alright. I should never have. I just wanted to do my stupid study.
I mean, neither of us saw this coming. It's, we just do what we can, you know. Do you know how much further it is?
It's about an hour or two, I think.
Look, I want you just to admit you're lost. I just want to understand the situation we're in. I don't want to just get mad.
Look, even if I was lost, what the hell would you do about it? You've been no help so far. I've been trying. I thought I knew where we were, but we've been walking for that long now. I don't even...
Thank you. I just... You're not going to like this idea. But the motorway. It's quite a walk away, and the wind makes it sound closer than it is. But as well as the weather and the flight paths, I've been studying the motorways. I know where it is.
Look, the car has to be close.
All right, we've been at this. We've been walking out here all day. Our friend is dead. And we need to stop taking risks and get back to civilization immediately.
Fine, let's go to the motorway.
Heather, slow down. My boots are waterproof, but the grip's no good in this mud. Heather, this route is a bit hazardous to be rushing through.
Look, this is the way to the motorway, and you said as fast to civilization as possible with the least risks. Tom? Tom, stop fucking about. Yeah? I'm gonna go get help, okay? I'm gonna go to the motorway and I'm gonna come back to help you. Okay? Just, I'm sorry, I have to, Tom. I'll be as quick as I can, okay? Just try and stay awake and stay still, okay?
Thank you.
I don't know where them pair have gone. I've been out, I've thrown up in my tent as well. They probably got lost. I don't know. Probably stayed out for the night or something. I really don't know. I don't know where they are. I'm gonna have to look for them.